are commonplace. All kinds of diseases, people are slipping away. The economy's down, folks can't get enough pay. As for me, all I can say is thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Yeah, yeah. Folks without homes are living out in the street. The drug habits, some say, they just can't beat. Muggers and robbers, no place seems to be safe. But you've been my protection every step of the way. And I gotta say, thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But that could have been me.
Thank you.
Thank you.
direction. Father God, for everything that you do in our lives, you're awesome, God. Father God, we want to say thank you. Father God, that you have eyes to see, thank you. Ears to hear, we thank you, Father God, for voices to talk. And Father God, we're not going to set down on you. We're going to lift up our praise to a holy and righteous God. Father God, we are so thankful, Heavenly Father God, for blessing us to travel down the highway, the danger highway, keeping us safe, Father God, and bringing us back to this place. Father God, we are so thankful. We are so grateful. We give you glory. We give you honor. All praises belong to you. In Christ Jesus' name we pray. And the church said amen. 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 It's so good to be in the house of the Lord today. Amen. Truly God is good. And he's good all the time. Amen. And we thank God for blessing us to come. Amen. To another service. Amen. It's so good to see you. It's so good to be in the house of God. Man, and we want you to take your Bibles today and go to Romans 6. Chapter 6. Man, I want to talk today from the subject, I reckon my life dead to sin. Amen. I reckon my life dead to sin. Amen. Not that, amen, we never would sin, because we are still in this fleshly body. Amen. But one thing that Paul is saying to us today, we don't have to sin.
That's right.
Amen. And he's also saying to us today that Jesus has crucified. Amen. Hallelujah. It's already done. We've been crucified with Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. So, amen. Anytime you might think about it, man, all we have to do is go to God.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
No longer we can say it like Flip Wilson, the devil made me do. Amen. So that's not correct biblically. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Because it's already done. Christ paid it. Amen. And beginning at verse 6. Amen. It said, knowing this, that our old man was crucified with him, that the body of sin might be done away with, that we should no longer be slaves of sin. Amen. For he who has died has been free from sin. Now, if we die with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him, knowing that Christ, having been raised from the dead, died no more. Death no longer have dominion over him. For the death that he died to sin once for all. But the life that he lived to God.
Amen.
Likewise, you also reckon yourself to be dead indeed to sin. Amen. But alive to God.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
In Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. I reckon my life dead to sin. Father God, once again, we are thankful. We are grateful, Father God, for your grace. We are grateful, Lord, for your mercy. Father God, we thank you for this time to stand and preach your word. Amen. To your people, Father God. Those that, Father God, around the world, wherever they might be, Father God, that the word, Father God, will be received, that they will understand what you're saying to the churches today. And Father God, I ask you to strengthen me, Father God, that I may speak it, Father God, the way you have placed it on my heart. And Father God, I don't take credit for what you do. I give you the glory, the honor, and the praise. All belongs to you in Christ Jesus. Amen. I reckon my life dead to sin. Amen. When Jesus died on the cross, the power of the flesh was broken. Amen. Hallelujah. As we see in verse 6, knowing this, that our old man was crucified with him, that the body of sin might be done away with. Amen. In other words, our fallen nature. Amen. The nature that Adam, amen, had been crucified by Christ. Nailed to the cross.
That's right.
The old life of Adam, we no longer live anymore.
That's right.
We are no longer controlled by sin. The old man was crucified with Christ, and the new man is resurrected and lived for Christ. Man, I am and you are now in the risen Christ. Amen. I am living in Christ. Sin no longer can reign as king in my mortal body. For Christ reigns as king in my mortal body. Amen. Not to say I will never sin, because I still live in this fleshly body. The Christian, amen, biggest problem is with our flesh. Amen. I believe I said that again. The Christian biggest problem is with the flesh. The flesh is still seeking to make its demand on us. Amen. Hallelujah. Romans 7:19 says, for the good that I will to do, I do not do. Amen. Hallelujah. But the evil I will not to do, that I practice. Hey, that was what Paul is saying. Hallelujah. Amen. There is a warfare that is going on in the Christian life. Amen. Hallelujah. The things that I want to do, those are the things I do not do. But the things I don't want to do, I find myself doing it. Amen. Galatians 5:17 says, for the flesh lusts against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary to one another. Amen. So that you do not do the thing that you wish to do. They are contrary. Amen. Spirit and the flesh are fighting with one another. Amen. There is a battle going on for the control of my mind. Control of my life. And the battle is between the flesh and the spirit. But one day, the battle will be over when the spirit leaves this body. body. Amen. Amen. I thank God for that. Amen. That I won't have to worry anymore about the fight that I have with this flesh. Live by. Amen. That's the Christian's biggest problem today. Amen. The battle is between my flesh and the spirit. Amen. Long as we live in this body, we are going to have some struggles. Some supremacies. The flesh against the spirit. But I hear Paul says in 1 Corinthians 9:27, and I'm coming from the Christian Standard Bible. Amen. I see the New Living Translation you will read up there on the screen. He said, instead, I discipline my body and bring it under strict control so that after preaching to others, I will not be disqualified. Amen. So Paul is saying, hallelujah, hallelujah. I discipline my body. In other words, amen, my body might want to do something I know is wrong. Amen. I cannot be out here in the streets, in the mall, in the store, doing any kind of way. Amen. And my people see me living any kind of way. So Paul said, amen, I have to discipline my body to bring it under strict control so that after preaching to others, I would not be disqualified. Amen. We Christians have to discipline our body. Huh? Hey, man, we can't just be out here doing any kind of way.
Right.
Now, reckon is a word of faith. Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen. It's a word of faith. If my flesh were dead, I would not have to reckon it to be dead. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Verse 10, Paul said, the death that Jesus died, he died to sin once and for all. Amen. Amen. And verse 11 says, likewise, you also reckon, amen, yourself to be dead indeed to sin.
Right.
Well, when my old life flares up, amen. When it flares up in me,
come on now.
I can cry out to God.
Amen.
And I can say, Lord, I reckon my body to be dead.
Yes.
That old part of my life. The things that I used to do. I reckon my own life to be dead.
Right, right.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank God. I do not have to live under the rules of the old life any longer, y'all. We don't have to live under that. Amen. Jesus is already, amen, crucified, and amen, the flesh. We don't have to live like that anymore. We now live in Christ. Can I get a witness? Verse 7 in this text of chapter 6 says, for he who has died has been freed. We are freed from sin. today. Now, if we die with Christ, we believe that we should also live with him. And when the believer accepts Jesus as their Lord and Savior, we are no longer slaves to sin. For he who has died has been freed from sin. Verse 12 says, therefore, do not let sin reign in your mortal body, that you should obey it in its lust. And in verse 13, and do not present your members as instruments of unrighteousness. Amen. I can't yield my body as an instrument in God's hand for God to use for his glory. Amen. My eyes, my ears, my hands, amen, my mind, and my mouth. I can present my members to fulfill the desires of my flesh and body, and be ruled by the desires of my body. Amen. Satan can use my body as an instrument of destruction. Man, a God can use my body as an instrument of glory. Man, Satan can use my life and fill it with hatred and cut people down. A God can use my life and fill it with love and build up people. Can I get a witness? We are exalted here to use our bodies as instruments of righteousness unto God. Amen. Can I get a witness? Verse 14 says, for sin shall not have dominion over you.
Come on now.
Amen. For you are not under the law, but under grace.
Amen.
Amen. Sin shall not have dominion over you. Amen. We are not under the law, but under the grace of God. Man, we cannot live a raggedy life and call ourselves a Christian.
Come on.
Huh?
Come on.
Amen. We can't live a raggedy life and talk about you Christian. You walking with God, yeah? Really? Amen. But this is what the word says, for sin shall not have dominion over you. Huh? Like I said, you can't say the devil made me do it. It don't have dominion over you. Amen. I put in my message today, give yourself this test. Give yourself this test. Now, I think we put it on the screen. Amen. Does anger have dominion over you? Amen. Does murmuring and complaining have dominion over you? Amen. Does covetousness have dominion over you? What about pride? Amen. And I like this one. Does laziness glory.
That's right.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
But he does promise us that sin will not have dominion over us.
Yeah.
Not because of our own righteousness, but because of the great works that Jesus did.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
On the cross.
Yeah.
Amen. Can I get a
witness? Yeah.
Amen. For you are not under the law, but we are under grace. Amen. Hallelujah. I thank God and I've been set free. Amen. No more chains holding me. I've been delivered and I've been set free. Can I get a witness? Sin have no dominion over me. Amen. For I am a child of the King. Amen. Are you a child of God? Can I get a witness? Amen. Check yourself. Amen. If you are living, amen, under some of those things I just mentioned. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you're backbiting and talking about one another. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't put it on God, because sin have no dominion over you. Amen. Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
We are saved and born again by the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Amen. We got a new life.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
Amen. We've been regenerated.
Yeah.
Amen. We've been washed in the blood.
Yeah.
Amen. Of Jesus.
That's
right. Sin no longer have dominion over us. Amen. And we ought to just go to God sometimes in prayer. Amen. And say, God, I want you to use, amen, my hands. Amen. God, I want you to use my eyes. Controlled by the nature of sin, amen, through Adam's.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
We have a new life.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. When Jesus died on the cross, the power of the flesh was broken.
Yeah.
Amen. Do you receive it today?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
No more chains.
Brother Bobby Brown is the father of Sister Crab. He's in the hospital. Amen. We want to pray that God strengthen his body. He's not doing well. He had operation on his brains. He had a mass. Amen. So on his brain. Amen. She was there on yesterday, the last night. I didn't think she was going to make it today. Amen. But thank God she's here. We're praying for her father. Amen. He's still in the hospital. Amen. We're going to pray, amen, for every person, amen, who sick or whatever going on in their life. Amen. But I want them to know that we are already delivered, amen, through Christ Jesus. Amen. For we sit in heavenly places with God because he is on the right hand and we are there. And we also want to pray for our essential workers. Amen. Come to that right there, sister. Amen. We also want to pray for our essential workers. Amen. That is on the screen. Amen. Those that are on the screen, those that are here today, amen. I thank God for them. Amen. And we want to pray for those that are at home, wherever they might be, those that might be working. Amen. Those that are at home. Amen. Truly, God is good. Amen. And we ask that you stand right now as we begin, as she's about to begin to pray. Amen. Amen. We want to say thank you in the name of Jesus. Amen. We can do all things through Christ.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, I ask right now that each and every one of us knit our hearts together in faith and believe that God would do just what he said. We've been calling on him for a long time. Now we just need to knit our hearts in faith with one another, touch and agree that he will do just what he said. Father knows everything. He knows everyone that is sick. He knows everyone that is afflicted. There are so many diseases, diabetes, high blood pressure, Crohn's disease, heart disease. There's the tumors, Lord God. Father God, we pray right now that you would touch those that are afflicted, that are sick, that are injured in their bodies. We pray a special prayer for Brother Brown right now, God. We know her heart is heavy because that's her father. But God, we know that you have the healing virtues in your hand. Oh, God, we know that the woman crawled and crawled until she touched the very hem of your garment. God, so we know we're touching your garment right now for healing. And we thank you, Lord God. We praise you, Lord God. We know that you are mighty God. We know that you are everlasting Father. We know that by grace we are saved. And God, we are your children. And we are you are our Father. So touch right now in the name of Jesus. In this house, we have many essential workers, God, that are out there on the battlefield, God, in this pandemic. But God, we know that the protection, they are shielded by you, God. You have a hedge of protection around them, God. Heal their bodies and protect them from this pandemic, God. Don't let anyone fall prey to anything that would destroy their bodies, their minds, their souls, God, in the name of Jesus. There are so many that are not here today, God, that could be here, but they are not here. God, for you know all about it. Oh, touch in a mighty way, God. Touch in a mighty way, God. That's all I'm asking you touch. Let the miracles from you, God. Oh, God, saturate this house, God. Touch each and every one that are here, God. Touch their home, that when they go back home, they'll find it in a place that they left it, God. In the name of Jesus. God, we love you today, and we give you praise. And all glory and honor is yours, God. In the name of Jesus, you do a work, God. You do a work, God. You do a work, God. Oh, God, I'm calling on you, God. to protect those that are not saved. You said the harvest are plenty. God, I have two sons out there, God, and I have a daughter out there. Oh, God, touch them this morning. God, you know they were brought up to know you and about you, and they strayed away. But I believe in my heart that they are coming back home. Not only my children, but all those that have strayed away from you, God. Strayed away from your word. Strayed away from that training, God. Send them back home. They know they are not living on their own. Oh, God, they are not breathing on their own. But, God, I'm praying for my children. I'm praying for other children. Those that such as to be saved in Jesus' name. You can do it, God. I pray for the college students. God, protect them in their dormitories. Protect them as they have to go back to school. Don't let them miss a beat, God. Don't let them miss a beat, God. Instill wisdom and intelligence in them, oh God. In the name of Jesus. God, we love you today. And we thank you and praise you today. All glory, all honor, and all praises belong to you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And amen. And amen.
And the church said amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Amen. We thank God, amen, for the service of today. Amen. And we truly pray that God bless you to be saved as we go back. Amen. It's so good to see. Amen. Mary, Lord, over there. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I think everybody in the sanctuary has been fascinated. Huh?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I see one family say no more than that, but I think basically we all. And we thank God for that. But I don't know what that means. I don't know if that means I can hug you or kiss you or what. I don't know. Sister Dream, what'd you say? You can't do that? What? I thought the shop was going to take care of everything. Oh, Lord. We still can't hug. Well, I don't know what to say about that, Deacon Jones. We still can't hug. Ain't that something? Amen. Even after being shot up. Amen. But we, you know, one day we're going to get through it.
Yeah.
Amen. Hopefully this year we'll get to do a couple of things. Amen. We're thinking about blessing the building.
Amen.
Of dedication. Hopefully we can do that. And hopefully by the end of the year, Sister Watson will preach this sermon right here. Amen. So those things we're planning on doing, we're thinking about it. Amen. But we'll be vigilant and make sure, you know, that it's going to be safe. Amen. Amen. So we thank y'all once again, and we're going to get ready to be dismissed.
All right.
Father God, we thank you once again for blessing us to come out to your house of worship. Father God, you've been so good. You're so kind. Father God, we just want to give you praise. We just want to say thank you. Father God, we thank you, Father God, for everything that you're doing in our lives, Father God. And we give you glory, honor, and the praise for all that you do. Yes. Father God, we are grateful, Father God. We are thankful, we're merciful, Father God, for all that you do. And Father God, we pray now, yes. Father God, that you keep the loving arms around us, Father God, that you keep us protected, Father God, as we leave this place to go to our various homes. Yeah. Amen. Now, in the grace of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, yeah, rest, rule, and abide with us until we meet again. And the church said, amen.
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 And amen.